We have exciting news. Many viewers sent a message asking what they might donate to the cause for saving the memorial. So please go to thefriendsofthecolosseum.org for more information. The link is right below.
Don't forget, any donation is tax deductible. The Friends of the Colosseum will send you a letter.
Yeah, let's continue exposing the bad guys who, just because they have billions and the cities under their spell, the city council, Weasel Carlos Valdez, Color.com, and many others that terrorize the veterans and us must stop. Ordering citizens not to sign the petition or else must stop. Yeah, let's give it to them. Yeah, the people. Hooray, the city works for us, not the other way around. Remember that, Corpus Christi.
I might as well give up trying to instill manners into you.
Don't stop trying, please, or we won't have an audience.
You're not in the least conceited, are you?
But you have to admit, for a little cotton-stuffed furball, I'm pretty cool, ain't I? My veteran buddies told me there's a lot of commotion around the memorial all of a sudden. My friends usually drive by the Colosseum at night. Yesterday they told me they heard very loud banging. We are now seriously concerned and wonder if someone is inside trying to violate the court order injunction and demolish the Colosseum, perhaps to tear it apart from the inside out.
Oh my, that's terrible.
Yeah, but we are on to them. The area around the memorial is now being watched by many of my veteran buddies who drive around the place 24/7 with night goggles.
Well, at least you're on to them.
What are you, a parrot? Jeez!
I'm just not saying much because I want you two to get all the attention.
Oh, and here I thought you were just a show-off.
Yeah.
I am so, so sorry. I suggest we post the phone number and email addresses of the Corpus Christi City Council so the Patriots of America can contact them, okay?
The official link for Corpus Christi is included in the sidebar. Everything is very easy to navigate.
Must have been someone other than the dudes on the council. It looks real good.
The dudes are ladies and gentlemen, by the way, and they are not responsible for the website.
So that's why it looks so good. What? Want me to carry a sign for your speech, Missy? Those nice people are messing with my buddy's Memorial Coliseum. It's outrageous what they do. They leave nasty messages on colortimes.com. They continue to malign good people. Of course, they're all being paid very well. Can't you sic a PI that's not scared of the lot after them and find out who is behind it all? Actually, we just need confirmation, you know. The people running ColorTimes.com are extremely biased and hypocritical, you know. They allow some of the most egregious comments, although their site states in part, you agree not to post comments that are defamatory, obscene, abusive, threatening, or an invasion of privacy, and violators may be banned. These rules must be the reason why the same names appear over and again, posting such nasty comments that normally would get anyone banned on a more professional site. Why make the rules? Then allow nice people to be trashed. I wonder how much Color.com gets paid. What?
Yeah, they ought to know that playing favorites is discriminatory and dangerous business.
Their motto is be as flagrant as possible, yes? So what happened?
I suggested removal of an especially nasty comment. However, this was wishful thinking and impossible.
But why? Don't they encourage you with their suggest removal comment? That's what I thought. But they say that I already have an account with them, although I never contacted them nor commented. Didn't even know they existed.
Sounds like even P.T. Barnum would appreciate an approve of their operation.
I tried to use the email address they said I had used before, to no avail. I kept getting error messages. Then I used another email address, but was only able to leave a message when I didn't mark suggest removal.
So much for Corpus Christi's Color.com being unbiased and honest. Who do you think pays them?
All I know is that if you do mark removal, they somehow connect your email address to other comments you made somewhere at some time on the internet and make it impossible for you to participate since you're obviously not agreeing with them.
In other words, they're as crooked as can be, huh? Yep.
Well, draw your own conclusions by what happened.
Same thing, no? Crooked as can be to me. Works just like the government, huh? Not only is Mr. Clower trying to save this award-winning building, but he came up with a wonderful concept. Please watch the video, Memorial Coliseum Festival Park and Pavilion, on this channel.
Just see how well the architect Mr. Clower illustrates. He shows us how beautiful and truly befitting to our veterans this project could become.
You know, I read a very interesting comment by Alsaman, quote, "Just follow the money trail. How much did Valdez cost? How much is the city in debt to ABC? Yep, follow the money trail," end quote.
It looks like the overseers oversaw that one and didn't remove very quickly, did they? Is Alsaman referring to Sue Happy City Attorney Carlos Valdez? My friends are on his trail. Watch all of our video exposés about the shenanigans, folks. You'll be glad you did.
I smell a bunch of rats, but I bet you the suckers that agreed and went along with the manipulators had no idea that they were lied to.
Yikes! Oh, guess what I found? How exciting is this? Did you see the headline, Weasel Carlos Valdez Takes Corpus Christi? They actually wrote Weasel! You got to admire someone cutting the weasel down a few notches. What? Stop that! I'm only repeating what I read. He thinks he's all that, you know. Going around threatening people, but they figured him out. And another headline, Valdez left Nuisa's Democratic Party in the lurch. He's well known, it looks like. Let's quote his own words.
Valdez asked the council to support him with their patience, prayers, and indulgence if he makes a mistake. "The task before me humbles me," Valdez said. "It seems odd that I would sit here and thank you for it, but I do. All my life, all I've ever wanted to do is serve. I don't make any promises to you other than one, to work as hard as I can." Yeah.
A first-year psychology student can figure out that his quote, "It seems odd that I would sit here and thank you for it, but I do," he is feeding the public a bunch of hogwash. It is customary for anyone voted into any type office to thank the voters, and no one would think it odd. This weasel is not even sure of himself and knows already that he's going to screw the people. What? Someone is pulling his strings. Wow, you're good. And he practically tells us he will make mistakes, as he calls it. I'd call weasel's mistakes something else, but then I just get pinched again. What? Valdez does work hard, all right, at threatening to sue not only organizations, but every individual in the organization separately. He goes after veterans and elderly people that try to save the memorial, scaring the daylights out of law-abiding citizens and suing them for exercising their civil rights. This goon's criminal activity is sanctioned by the city. He should be disbarred ASAP. Weasel Carlos Valdez has overstepped his bounds for far too long.
I didn't know that.